shipping in some way or another, directly or indirectly, touches every single human on the planet.
Without shipping, there is no global trade.
Every object you see around us right now, 80 to 95% has been shipped. So it's absolutely massive on our everyday life. But it also has its dark sides.
Shipping is one of the most severe polluters in the world right now. We need to change that from being dirty, short-termist, to green and responsible. This presents the greatest single opportunity for investors and our shareholders that the world's seen in at least 100 years.
My dream is that one day, when a large ship enters a big industrial port, the water in that port is so crystal clear and so full of fish. That's what we need to achieve in shipping.
Ocean health is completely important because every second breath you have taken, it comes out of the ocean. As soon as that ocean stops absorbing carbon and releasing oxygen, we face, as organic life humanity, a very uncertain future. Outside of that, billions of people around the world have their livelihoods dependent upon it. Continuing to pollute it will eventually destroy us all. We absolutely must protect it, but shipping has a major impact. Every ship owner in the world has the opportunity to lean forward, have a touch of vision, and turn the industry to zero pollution. And technology for this is getting better and better and better.
It's important to look at the entire industry, looking at the ship operators, the ship builders, the fuel suppliers, the port operators, and bring all of them in. I see a big commercial opportunity for technology companies to make the marine industry more sustainable, more efficient. Aviva is an industrial software company. Today, you can design a ship fully in the cloud, including very complex ships with more than 3 million data points. You can then take that digital twin of a ship and use it to mirror the operations of the ship. We can collect data from these ships and then run predictive analytics, and you can optimize entire fleets that way. You will not just build them significantly faster, you will also cut your fuel consumption and the emissions they produced by about a third. And that also then makes the mode of shipping much more sustainable. Profitability and sustainability do go hand in hand.
At Bluenose, we're really innovating on how to address the aerodynamics of any given ships to reduce emissions through efficiency improvements. One of our main products is a wind deflector that we put at the front of the ships in order to reduce air drag and thus reduce fuel consumption. Today, there are around 5,000 container ships that are viable for our solution that represent an impact of $5 billion of saving and 11 million tons of CO2 each year. That's almost 2.2 million cars off the roads each year.
The world needs energy which doesn't destroy the planet. But the only energy source we're being offered is one which is going to destroy the very future of organic life, particularly humanity, which we seek to enhance. We're going to transition away from bunker sea oil. We're going to transition away from diesel. We should be transitioning straight into green fuels.
The Green Pioneer now is the world's first dual-fuel ammonia ship. The benefits are widely known, and that is that it is a carbon-free fuel, and that it is produced principally from what we are breathing in with nitrogen and hydrogen, which we produce through electrolysis. So it has very, very strong green credentials compared to continuing to burn fossil fuel. So you significantly reduce your carbon intensity. It is the fuel that will be replacing the fossil fuel in shipping.
When you take an ecosystem approach to the marine industry, and you think not just about designing a ship, building a ship, operating a ship, but also about the ports, then you realize that ports are actually massive cities in their own right. And they can become smart cities today, where a port understands all the data, the logistics data, the people data, the energy flows, everything that goes through the port, and provides this data to the marine supply chain. And that is where the power of data, the ability to analyze and to run predictive analytics across the entire ecosystem becomes so powerful. These solutions can scale today. The capabilities exist. There are no technical boundaries to achieving the goals set for shipping.
Our structures are able to adapt to varying operational conditions. If we had all the funds and the facilities, we can easily deploy at scale. And it was really important in the design of our solution to make sure that it would be easily scalable.
Without any doubt, we can produce shipping fuel all over the world. That's, I think, incredibly important because we can mass produce it purely from the sun and the wind you're feeling right now rolling across your skin.
The technology is available today, and that is really what the Green Pioneer has demonstrated, is continuing to demonstrate to the world.
Scaling what is available today in terms of technology across the marine industry in general means that you will have cleaner seas, you will have less greenhouse emissions. There's a real opportunity for those that leapfrog in the industry and are the first to become much more efficient and yet also have a positive impact on the planet.
I think the biggest challenge we have is short-termism and deeply vested interests with solid knowledge gaps in their thinking, where senior politicians in countries are being told there is no way to a green future.
We delivered a project without a rule book. I think what was then the achievement of the project is we then helped write that rule book, which in December last year at the IMO MSC was adopted for the interim guidelines for the use of ammonia.
Most great innovations came when people, when companies, when nations learn from each other. This is true in any business, in any industry, and this is certainly also true in shipping.
This ship has sailed the right direction. Let's keep sailing. When we've got a rising technology able to give us a much higher standard of living, then we know we're serving everyone on the planet. It's that obvious. Time to go green is now. That's the future of shipping. Mm-hmm.